Hello and welcome to Simplified on PowerDrift, where we take complicated automotive ideas and break them down into something simple. And today we're talking about slipper clutches. If you haven't, this would be a good time to subscribe and do hit the bell notification icon, because honestly, do you really want to miss out? So, slipper clutches. Now, slipper clutches appeared on the racing scene a few years ago, and now they're pretty commonplace in motorcycles. What do they do? Now, think about your four-stroke engine. It's got a lot of moving parts, right? There's valves, there's cams, the piston, conrods, everything is moving. And while it's doing its job, it's driving the rear wheel. But think about a situation where you closed the throttle or made a very aggressive downshift. In this situation, the rear wheel is continuing to rotate at the speed you last left it at, which is inertia. But now the engine has slowed down considerably. And therefore, now what the rear wheel is trying to do is trying to drive the engine. We perceive this as engine braking. We also call this back torque, and that's why a slipper clutch technical term is a back torque limiting clutch. And the idea is that once the rear wheel starts to try to drive the engine and fails, what will happen is the rear wheel will lock and it will cause a little bit of a loss of control. It can be momentary, but it can delay you, it can upset you, it can damage your confidence, and that's where a slipper clutch comes in. In function, a slipper clutch is not very different from a zip tie. So if you've seen a zip tie, it's got a little rectangular head on one side and it's got a tail. Now when you thread the tail back through the head, it only moves in one direction. So you can continue to tighten a zip tie, but loosening a zip tie is quite a bit more work. It can be done, but you need to have a little screwdriver or something to take off the little lock block, right? In the very same way, a slipper clutch can work very well while the engine is rotating forward. But when the rear wheel tries to drive the engine, the clutch starts to slip. And it effectively disconnects the engine from the rear wheel. So even if there is a difference in the engine speed and the relevant speed for the rear wheel will not lock up, it will continue to spin. And that's essentially what a slipper clutch does. The mechanism it does this is what we call ramps. If you've ever seen curbs at a racetrack, you'll notice that there are triangles like this which end in a hard surface. If you ride a motorcycle this way, it can be a little bumpy, but it's not hard to do because the hard surface never actually meets the wheel. But try riding the curbs this way and you're constantly meeting hard surfaces, and that makes the experience extremely uncomfortable to the point where most racetracks are designed to run in one direction, and therefore the curbs are always designed like that. A slipper clutch exactly does the same thing. It's got triangle ramps like this, and as long as the motion is in this direction, it's quite smooth because it can keep moving. But when the direction goes against it, it hits a hard surface and it can no longer move, and that's how a slipper clutch works. A clutch in itself is a whole different topic, we'll discuss it in detail, but here's what you need to know about slipper clutches in terms of living with them. The biggest advantage that you will get from a slipper clutch riding around every day is that once you have a slipper clutch in play, the manufacturer can reduce the weight of the springs they're using in the clutch, which means that the amount of effort you need to actuate the clutch off the lever is much lower. And that's why those clutches are technically called slip and assist clutches, because they have a slipper function as well as an assist function, which means that your lever requires less effort to operate. Obviously, if you know your clutches, you should know that before slip and assist clutches, which are still cable-driven clutches, were invented, hydraulic clutches were created to reduce the effort, where a hydraulic system, not dissimilar to what you use for your disc brakes, was used to amplify the effort. So the clutch effort could be light, but the clutch springs could be really hard if needed. That's true for fast engines, where lots of power and torque is being transmitted through the clutch, and therefore you need a very strong clutch. A slip and assist clutch can have a very strong clutch but make the effort lower, and that's your biggest advantage. The actual advantage of a slipper clutch from the racing application side is that you can have very aggressive downshifts, big differences in the speed of the engine and the rear wheel, and still not have the rear wheel lock up. What happens when the rear wheel lock up is that for that moment you don't really have control over the motorcycle. So for example, let's say you're going into a left hand corner, you've downshifted too aggressively and the rear wheel starts to lock and hop. Your motorcycle is going to be unsettled, which means you will have to wait for it to settle before you can turn the motorcycle, unless you're a rider of extremely high skill. What a slipper clutch does is it intervenes at that point and allows the rear wheel to rotate so that your contact patches, your contact surfaces are still stable and controllable, which means even though the engine's quite unhappy at this time, the slipper clutch is absorbing the strain so you can carry on riding, which means you can turn your motorcycle as soon as you're ready to. In effect, in today's world, riding a motorcycle with a slipper clutch in the rear wheel doesn't really have a performance advantage unless you're riding really, really hard. But think about it like this. As India becomes a country that's more aware of the traffic laws and more willing to follow them, as the penalties and enforcement become stronger, as you and me, the motorcyclists, become more responsible, riding in a way where a slipper clutch will give you an actual riding advantage up a mountain road when you're out riding with your friends is very, very little. So the reason to get a slipper clutch for you is if you make a bad gear change, the slipper clutch absorbs the disadvantage that you gain from it, and it reduces the clutch effort that you need to operate the motorcycle. That's really it. So, when a manufacturer puts on an advertisement saying such and such motorcycle now has a slipper clutch, think about it. If you go to a racetrack, you will be able to use this technology. Every day in traffic, it will reduce your lever effort. But outside of that, in the application that this motorcycle is going to be used, it doesn't really do anything else. Thank you so much for watching. This is Simplified on PowerDrift. If there's other things about slipper clutches that you'd like to discuss, leave us a comment. If there's other topics that you're thinking of that we should really, really be talking about, leave us a comment as well. I know you've subscribed. Thank you so much for that. And thank you so much for watching.